by the flowing music scene, or something getting pulled or scrambled by a single kind of slipper.
Let's see if we can not get our guys killed today. Alright, so Bruno's gonna scavenge as usual. No, not Bruno. Marco, he's got the bigger backpack. I think Pavel's gonna guard tonight, and Bruno will sleep in the bed. We need to get food and supplies. I think we'll try this again. Hopefully we don't encounter any strange peoples. These guys attacked me last time. I think maybe if you kill the people who are there, somebody else might come in. I don't know yet. But if you leave one person alive, then maybe when you come back, only that one person will be there. I don't know. We'll see. See what else I can find. She's crying like a little bitch. What is that? Let's see. Medicines? Medicines! I think that's a better deal. Holy crap, look at all this food. I'm gonna have to come back. Marco's injured. He got stabbed. Yeah, when you get all those, all the wood and all those other components, you can upgrade your craft tables and such. He's sad. Oh no, we were raided. Oh crap. That's no good. Holy shit. Alright. Got some wounds to take care of. He doesn't like the fact that he killed peoples. Why won't he move? Oh, he's broken. They broke his spirit. Those damn people that he had to kill. He won't move, that summon a bitch. Holy shit. Maybe if I sell him a gun. Wonder how long he'll stay broken. He won't move now. I don't know what to do about it. I guess we need to do something kind. Oh yeah, maybe he needs some. I didn't realize you could interact with the other inhabitants. So I told her to bandage him. Nice. He still won't move, though. I gotta get Marco in bed. He won't go to bed. I'm gonna make some more filters so I can do more water. She's cheering him up. Ah, maybe that'll help. Interesting. Okay, so he can't scavenge because he's depressed, so he needs to sleep. I guess Katia will be my scavenger tonight. And Pavel, no, he's wounded. Oh, yeah, I guess he's the least wounded. He'll be guard. We'll go to the house. See what we can find. I guess I can't talk to them. Wonder if they'll be upset if I scavenge. Sorry, buddy. Gots to have food. I haven't. Do you know what sugar's good for? I don't make alcohol, so I guess I don't need sugar. Let's see. Herbs, I think, good for food. Need the meds. I think that'll do. I don't know how to avoid that. I think it's probably, she's probably going to take a happiness hit because I just robbed those people. Oh no, lucky 13. Now she's broke. Oh, he's gonna stay in bed, that little turkey. Wonder if meds will help him. I guess not. Oh, sweet. Have him sit in a comfy chair, maybe that'll make him happier. Nice. I can make barricades now. Yep, I can see it. She's going to be broken next. We need somebody to come knock at the door who says, I need your help. And then we can send her to help, or someone. That's kind of cool. Oh, we got to start working on this. Growing plants inside. Yeah, we got to start doing this. Oh, hell yeah. Reinforced doors. I guess I'll have her eat again. She's still hungry. Wow. Marco's still depressed. I'm gonna have Pavel stand guard, I guess. See how this works out. Oh, shit. Alright. Fist, wait, where the fuck's the gun? Oh no!
User joined your channel.
She got shot, son of a bitch.
Why are you sitting back here all by yourself?
I'm playing a game, man.
Alright.
What are you up to?
I just woke up.
I'm playing This War of Mine.
I've never heard of that.
It's pretty freaking awesome.
We'll have to check it out.
Yeah, I'm streaming it right now.
We're gonna have to run a vanilla server.
Why is that?
What was it? Like 200 something megabytes of RAM. It's just not enough for the Beat the Beast stuff. I think it's 173 mods. It tries to load them and goes, nope, fuck you.
We can upgrade that server if you guys want.
It wouldn't be, it'd cost you too much.
I don't think so.
I researched a little bit and Nick looked at it. And to get, like, in a halfway decent server, we'd need 2 gigabytes.
Okay. So you're looking at probably less than $20 then?
Not according to that place you told me you get servers from.
Well, it's less than $1 a slot.
Hang on. Still have it. Gotta find it in my history.
Game servers. It's gameservers.com.
Aw, don't make it too easy for me.
This game's pretty awesome.
What is it? First-person shooter?
No, it's kind of like a side-scroller. And it's basically DayZ, but in a side-scroller kind of a layout. You start out with 3 people, and you're like, you have a base, a house, and you have to go out and scavenge at night and, you know, loot things and try to make your team happy. You know, they get wounds and you have to bandage them. They get sick and you have to give them meds. You know, they get hungry, you got to feed them. They get tired, you got to make them sleep. You build craft tables and, you know, places to cook food and, you know, things to keep warm. It's pretty awesome.
Yeah, that's $40 a month. That's not worth the money. Wow, those things get expensive fast.
They do. I didn't get a whole lot of supplies last night.
For what?
Scavenging. Ooh, I can make another. Nice. I can board up my house. Again.
Again? What happened the first time?
Well, it's a post-apocalyptic world, so the house that we took over is like, you know, it's got holes in the walls and stuff. You can watch my Twitch stream and see the game. It's twitch.tv/Echo9Hotel.
I bet you never have issues with other people having your username, do you?
Nope. Well, once in a great while I do. What What did she just say? I missed that. Maybe I can have him make another bed. He's complaining about not having a bed.
Tell him he's lucky to be alive. Quit bitching.
I don't have enough supplies. I got two beds as it is, so...
Are they computer players or other players?
You control them. You control all the players.
Excuse me.
That, client that comes with that server, that makes it incredibly easy to set up stuff, though.
Mm-hmm.
Wish, we'd known about that a while ago. The, Feed the Beast servers that we were gonna set up, I actually have, like, one-click setup for that thing.
Nice. Wow, that was quick.
Did all your hopes and dreams get smashed?
No.
Oh, bummer.
I'm not taking any weapons with me this time.
Balls deep.
Oh shit, I forgot there were guys here with guns.
Sounds like weapons might be a good idea, Echo.
Too late. You can't go back to the house once you've left. Until you're done for the night.
Sounds like you might be in a bit of a pickle.
I am.
Scared little bitch mode. Activate.
Guess I'll be taking whatever I can get a hold of. Not much. Gun parts. I don't really need them. Ooh, holy shit. Oh, crap, crap, crap! Oh shit, this guy sees me. Ooh, I'm hiding. Move along. This is not the scavenger you're looking for.
Get out there and fight. Don't be a pansy. It's only a couple guns. Come on now.
I have faith in you, Echo. You can do it.
Man, this place is awesome. Oh shit. Oh shit.
Run, Echo, run.
Oh fuck.
Did they get you?
I think so. Oh no, I died! No! Katia! No! Damn it!
Do you lose all your stuff when you die, or you just kind of respawn?
I lose all the stuff that she had on her when she was scavenging, and now I'm down to 3. Oh man! Oh, you start with 3, and then over time you can accumulate new, like, team members. New people in your house, and so I had gotten up to 4, and now fuck, now she's dead. No, Katia, no, come back.
The good always die young.
Wow, should have taken a gun. Damn it. Oh, and I got fucking raided. Wow.
You know what would have fixed this problem? A really big gun.
Right? Santa Beaches! Well, that's not gonna help the depression level in the house, that's for sure. Shit.
Wow, they can actually get depressed?
Oh yeah, they get sad. You gotta talk to them, cheer them up, give them a little pep talk. Huh.
Alright guys, I know we're all dying off one by one, but you're doing good.
Hey, she had it coming.
Wow.
I'm gonna make myself some hot food.
I would, but I try to avoid using the stove. I'm a menace to society when I cook.
Now I got another one that's fucking broken.
Another
when they get, you know, when you say a man is broken or a woman is broken, you know, they're like so depressed, they're like catatonic.
Oh, wow, you can actually get, that's
yeah.
Too realistic.
So they will basically get to a point to where they will sit there and not do nothing. You can't make them go eat. You can't make them go sleep. They're basically useless in your house.
I'd shoot them. They'll get off their ass and do some work, or I'm gonna shoot you.
The chick that just died. She was my my trader. She had bargaining skills. Oh fuck! Sure enough, and the fucking trader just shows up. Son of a bitch.
Well, the other players can trade, can't they?
Yeah, but she, like, has proficiency, you know, so she, I guess, gets better deals.
Yeah.
I think that's how that works.
Trader's trying to figure out where your players are, and...
Well, yeah.
You see that lump of red mist outside?
This guy, he's got some decent stuff, but I don't really, he's got the same stuff I have, except I need his parts, components. I wonder what.
Take it.
You can't.
What?
You don't. You don't get that option.
Hey, okay. Apocalypse. I think you should be able to kill him and take a shit.
Yeah, maybe. Homeboy's still in bed. He needs to get his ass up.
The depressed guy?
Oh my god, they took all our food. I got raided last night and they took all my food. Oh no. Homeboy's catatonic. Oh, Bruno's gonna die too. He's lethally wounded. This isn't gonna end well. This is like part two of the series, and my guys are all gonna die.
Kind of depressing.
Yeah, I played for 90 minutes last night and posted it up on the website. I've been playing for like 45 minutes today, and it's like 180 degree turn from the direction I was going last night. It all looked so well last night. Everybody was eating, I had gear, I was upgrading my craft tables.
Then everything went to shit.
Oh man. Oh my gosh. Sunt of beaches. Well, I guess nothing to do but end the day and try to go scavenge again. My freaking scavenger, he's so depressed he won't scavenge for me. So I guess he can frickin' guard.
He's still sitting in the corner rocking in the fetal position?
I don't, man, that guy. I don't know if I need to take bullets or not. I wasn't getting the shotgun option last time when I took a weapon. I'm gonna try it again and see what happens. But if I kill somebody, they're gonna be upset about it.
I'd kinda be upset too, you know?
If you kill people while you're scavenging, it like makes everybody depressed. What have we come to? Yeah, see, I have a shotgun, but I have no option to shoot anybody. The only option I have is to use my fists.
They get depressed if you shoot someone that's trying to raid you or kill you?
No, they get depressed if I go scavenging and then I kill people while I'm scavenging.
Oh, like unnecessary violence?
Yeah, yeah.
Tell him to man up.
This dude's got a gun. He's standing right on the other side of this door. I'm gonna see if I can bum rush him. Punch him out. Oh, he keeps hitting me with a gun. Oh, he killed. Oh, Pavel's dead. Pavel's dead! No!
It's pretty sad when you get killed by the gun and it wasn't even fired.
Oh. That's. Oh my. What the fuck? Crap. Down to two now, and one of them is freaking gonna die.
Still catatonic.
Marco has some ugly wounds. It seems very serious. Bruno is bleeding. It doesn't look like he's gonna make it. Crap.
It's to be Bruno.
And Marco's the one who's catatonic right now. I can't even make him move to go get like bandages or anything. Ugh, Bruno is lethally wounded. But it says he's recovering. Well, crap. Wonder if I can
cover from a lethal wound.
I wouldn't think so. And neither of them will scavenge! Oh, they're both gonna sleep. Oh, crap. I think this might be the end.
Goodbye, cruel world.
Oh, Bruno died. Look at that! 3 days in a row. Recovering. 3 days in a row. Wow. Marco's bleeding.
What happens if all your people die? You just start over?
Yeah, it's over. I mean, my last guy won't do anything. I can't, you know, so I can't do anything except advance to the next. There's like a oh shit, Marco committed suicide. Fuck! Wow. So there's like, you know, the clock ticks, and at the end of the day, you go into the night schedule. And then at night, you have to pick somebody to either scavenge, tell people to sleep, tell people to guard, etc. If you don't have somebody guarding your house, then, you know, you get, when, if you get raided, they take more stuff. If you have somebody guarding, then I think, you know, there's less of a chance of that. If you don't want to send somebody scavenging, you don't have to. But if you don't go scavenge, then you don't get resources. You can't go get, like, materials or food or whatever. When you start, the house has, like, a set amount of resources, like, in it that you can explore the house and the house that you're using as your base. And you can find medicines and food and, you know, a certain amount. But you're going to run out of that quickly. So you have to go scavenge the city to try to find more resources. And then you bring them back at the end of the night. And then you start the next day.
So if you ain't got anyone that'll scavenge, you're pretty much screwed.
Yeah, and my last guy was the catatonic dude who won't do anything. So it won't let me set him to scavenge. So all I can do is advance to the next day and tell him to stay at the house and sleep. And overnight he committed suicide. You know what's interesting? It says Marco committed suicide. He was the last one alive, and it says we found Marco dead. I want to know who that is, because everyone else died yesterday. Okay, well, I didn't make it. I survived for 18 days. Oh, well, it was a good run. Tough decision. Pavel robbed someone, taking almost everything they had. Day two. What does it say? Day three, a sniper's victim. Our neighbor got wounded by a sniper bullet. Katia helped carry him to safety. Day 10 was a plea for help. Our neighbor felt unsafe and asked us to help her board up her windows. We did that. Day 11, violent murder. Marco murdered several people.
Shame on Marco.
I think that was the turning point. Katia died. Katia was killed while looking for supplies. It's scrolling through, like, pictures of, like a journal. And it's, like, Polaroid images. Pavel died. Day 15, Pavel was killed while looking for supplies. Day 17. Yep. Bruno died. Bruno died of severe wounds. And day 18, we lost Marco. He couldn't take it anymore and committed suicide.
A little bit dark.
It is. Well, Katia never found her parents, but they did find her grave one day with her diary buried alongside. They published it without any alterations and became a bestseller. Sadly, Pavel died with his family. Will his family come back to Pogorin to visit his grave one day, or would it be too painful, a reminder of what they had gone through? Do the dead even care? Despite his valiant struggle, Bruno didn't make it through the war. The fate of his friend he was worried about remains unknown. Broken, Marco lost all hope of ever reaching his wife and daughter. Along with hope, he also lost his will to live on. He left them a goodbye letter, but no one passed it on to them.
Wow, that is dark.
What's up?
This game that I'm playing.
Oh. What's up, Nick? Not much.
Well, I guess that's the end of part two of that little series, so I'm going to end.